64th running of the Spa 24 Hours is a little under half an hour away from getting underway. A 66-car grid here for 24 Hours, the fourth round of the Blancpain Endurance Series. And it has been quite a week so far, with not just this enormous entry, but also a fascinating qualifying session on Thursday evening, running into the night, with a number of red flags interrupting things. And then Super Pole yesterday for the top 20 drivers, ultimately being rained off. We had this sudden downpour of rain, and that put the mockers on that. Round four of the Blancpain Endurance Series, the Total 24 Hours of Spa gets underway now, then as the race accelerates down towards Eau Rouge for the first time, with a really brave Nico Verdon going up on the inside on the grass and on the curve to back fourth place, and Maxime Martin round the outside leads the race coming out of Eau Rouge for the first time at Radio. Really brave stuff. Maxime Martin on home soil wants to lead the first lap, and he does lead thus far. It's going to be Maxime Martin who leads the way. Alvaro Perrin up into third spot in the McLaren, trying to repel Nico Verdon's challenge as the cars now head their way out of Les Cornes for the first time. Also, Peter Cox has made a good start. Ben Schneider of the Mercedes getting stuck in as well. So Coronel, Schneider, Lotterer, and the cars swoop their way now through Eau Rouge. Yeah, this is Matt Griffin's Ferrari with the bonnet on the left-hand side. Gravel is where Koen Wouters has parked the Mercedes, I'm afraid to say. Maxime Martin is leading the way, still second is Kettler, and third is Alvaro Perrin leading his class. Alvaro going well. There, more drama as Adam Christodoulou tries to go for the pit lane. Adam Christodoulou has been excluded from the race. And this is the sister car, number four, Mike Hazeman's, limping to the pit lane. Number four, Marc VDS car, as has oft been the case this year, has got problems. Now, is it going to be drizzle, or is this going to really set in? And it is most definitely raining. This is the wet part, quite evidently. No grip, nothing, bang. Big impact into the tyre barrier. And this is what's going on now. Safety car period that I fear is going to be a long one, looking at the weather conditions. This is really grim now. And it stops. It stops. He has to restart the car. We are about to go racing once again. So Rani Rast is storming away. That is a big accident coming out of Blanchimont. There is a Porsche off the road in a huge way. That is a monster, and the safety car is deployed for the second time. It is raining once again. At the moment, we've got an Audi 1-2. Lights are out. The safety car is going to be in this time, and so we can go back to racing. Off the road is the 59 Ferrari. That's the Vita 41 Team Italy car. Thank you. welcome to a sunny Spa, the weather far better than we had yesterday evening. This is the race leading car on track now. It's Andrea Ficini at the wheel and the car has got a puncture. The leader limping to the pit lane. Stefano Telli comes through to pick up the race lead. There is the car that's currently running in fifth place, Frank Kettler. Dropping away, in fact. The car has climbed back up the order after a few slow pit stops last night, being delayed under safety cars and so forth. There is the car leading Pro-Am. Gaetano Aldana at the wheel, the Venezuelan in the Ferrari. There's a Ferrari in real strife there, going way, way off the road over the grass. Is that one of the Kessel racing cars? It is. It's lost a wheel, and that looks like Zampieri from 15th place. Daniel Zampieri at Lecom. And while all this is going on, so Frank Stippler is getting closer and closer and closer. This monster traffic jam coming up to Lecom. Stippler is on the inside line for the race lead. He's going to go through. Frank Stippler leads, going into Lecom. Onto the curb goes Christopher Hasler. He's going to have to go up the escape road. There he does. And that is Sandstrom off the road, big time.
I hit the inside curb too hard and it unsettles the cars quite heavily.
And that looks like the end for number two. And that's a Ferrari that is off. So this is the 16th safety car period. That is a monster accident. That is a huge, huge accident. Into the pit lane comes Ortelli. So they're going to refuel it. And turns in. And suddenly almost does a U-turn. Now, if Adam Christodoulou can get excluded from the race for an unsafe pit lane entry, people might want to have a look at that one, because that was very strange. And a drive-through penalty for Stefano Ortelli as well for crossing the white line pit entry. So that slightly dubious entry to the pit lane has caught them out. Number one, Stefano Ortelli down the pit road. Mark Hayek has just brought it in. Now this is Mark Hayek on the grass, which may have done a bit of damage to the front of the car. And we'll go on to that last lap any moment. Line themselves up side by side as they come over the timing line. And victory goes to Stippler, Ficini and Rast. How about this to get the Mustang over the timing line? It's a big, big, heavy car and a great effort this. And a punctured tyre on the last lap and a spin. This is Frank Kettler at the last corner. Oh, an exhausted Frank Stippler sits by the side of the car. Massive Stauder, Frank Kettler and Greg Franchi. The second place team onto the podium. Christopher Haas, Christopher Mies and Stefano Ortelli. For René Rast, Andrea Ficini, and for Frank Stippler, who makes his way onto the podium. A job well done indeed.